My name is Lisa Wozniak, and I'm a marketing strategist with Woz Marketing. Are you stuck on how to actually get paying clients through networking? Watch this video for my foolproof networking formula. We'll have you growing your practice in no time. For the best marketing advice in your private practice, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell. You'll be notified when I post a new video every week. If you're uncomfortable with networking and don't know how to get paying clients from it, don't worry. By the end of this video, you'll have my four-step formula that can be your go-to plan for landing your next paying client. No hard sale necessary. I've proven this formula on countless practitioners, and now it's your turn. Okay, step number one. Establish the relationship. You know, the biggest mistake that I see people make in networking is they're so worried about how uncomfortable it feels that they kind of plug their nose, hold their breath, and they jump in right away with asking for the sale. They do it too soon. Take the time to get to know people first. Establish the relationship. When you focus all of your attention on them and ways that you can be supportive of them, it makes getting them as a client so much easier. Remember, people will buy from those that they know, like, and trust. If you come out of the gate with a hard sell too soon, you'll lose them before you ever even had them. Step number two. Since you are building the relationship with this person, take the time to understand their pain points, their struggles, and their challenges. Take that relationship to the next level to learn what some of the things are that they're struggling with. This positions you better than ever to be able to find a way to offer your services to them. If you know what they're struggling with, you know how you can help them, which makes getting them as a client so much easier. Now, speaking of pain points, I would love to know in the comments below, what are some of the questions that you ask when you meet someone to discover what their pain points are? Comment with that below. Okay, now, step number three. When you're networking with someone, make sure that you offer something of value as you're building that relationship. So often when we're networking, we immediately get the wall from someone, right? The wall goes up because they're thinking, what are they trying to sell me? What do they want from me? How much is it going to cost me? What do they need from me? That kind of thing. And one of the ways that you can break down that wall is to give something of value to them. And that can be as simple as a strategic introduction from someone in your network, someone that you can refer to them, an article or a book that they can read. And most importantly, when you're trying to gain them as a client, you can offer small amounts of free advice. Now, obviously, you don't want to give away the bank here, right? But you can get them started on the right path. You can offer small nuggets of free advice to them. And once they get that taste of your expertise, it makes it so much easier to get them as a client. Now, if you feel like you're getting the hang of this networking thing, and you're feeling courageous enough to take it to the next level, I invite you to watch my video, Partnership Projects in Private Practice, 4 P's. It's on my YouTube channel, and the video is yours to watch for free. Check it out. Okay, step number four in how to get clients through networking is follow-up. Now, you can follow up with them through email, or you can follow up with them by phone, or even in person. But really, the best way to maintain constant follow-up with them is to get them on your email or newsletter list. Ask them permission to put them on your newsletter list. it's really the best way for them to continue to hear from you on a regular basis and see why they need to become your next client. If you don't already have an email marketing plan in place, I have a series of videos on my YouTube channel that will explain how to do that, but that's really step number four. Make sure that you're following up with them on a regular basis. Now you know exactly how to get clients from your networking efforts. But how do you maintain your networking growth strategy and keep track of all of these people that you've acquired along the way? Well, I've written several blogs on the subject, and you'll learn how to do this in my step-by-step systematic process. The good news is it's yours for free, and the link is in the description below. Now, if you like this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribe, and share it with your fellow practitioners. And if you would, comment below with the word helpful. This lets me know what kind of content resonates with you the most and what kind of content we should be creating next. This is Lisa Wozniak with Woz Marketing, helping you navigate your yellow brick road. Have a great day, everybody. Thank you.